What if a ballistic missile is launched against military forces or even NATO alliance territory? To test engaging a ballistic missile threat in flight, the German-led exercise Rapid Arrow was used to see if NATO's missile defense system was able to intercept the missile.
2063 is clear to engage.
Rapid Arrow, for the first time, we were testing the entire system. And it was important because we have done for the first time the entire cycle.
Up until now, the threats were only simulated and did not include firing a real interceptor missile.
This time we had an actual ballistic missile launched against the target area. And that makes obviously a considerable difference because it had realism to the exercise.
During the exercise, the NATO command and control structure that comes into play when a ballistic missile is detected was tested.
As this whole event only lasted about 5 minutes from the launch of the target missile to the final engagement, it also shows how critical a good functioning C2 system is to the overall command and control process, because time is very limited. We cannot pick up the phone and dial some number and try to get some people which we need to talk to. Everything must be functioning perfectly and working perfectly in order to really do command and control of missile defense.
NATO's missile defense system consists of the sum of national missile defense assets networked together. In this case, it meant that the radar of the US ship, the USS Sullivan's, picked up the target missile and passed the information to a German Patriot battery at the NATO missile firing installation in Crete to help it conduct an intercept.
From this headquarters here at Ramstein, we could see everything, the detection of the launch, the tracking of the target missile going inbound into the target area, and then the engagement process. And we could have engaged in the engagement process if we considered it necessary, for instance, to order a hold fire on the engagement process. That could have worked.
The live fire test, in which the target was successfully acquired and destroyed, is an important step in the development of NATO's missile defense capability.
We could use it if we needed to do. At the moment, there are no indications and warnings that tensions are high, that we are under the threat of a ballistic missile attack, but we could use it if the situations would change.
The exercise also proved that there's no delay in the information flow between the US and the NATO missile defense systems. The next step is to improve and broaden the missile defense protection from protecting NATO military forces to also protecting its territory and populations.
Up to now, we have been dealing exclusively with the defense of forces. For the defense of forces, there are some criteria. The forces are, for example, trained, are to a certain extent hardened, can be dispersed. Obviously, the populations and territory and city are not. So we need to have different criteria to deal also with these additional requirements.
That way the civilian population can also be alerted and warned in case of a missile threat. I'm Carsten Reiniers, reporting for the NATO channel from Ramstein, Germany.